Not everyone is tolerant.
This is what you represent.
It is legal to yell. But prejudice can escalate into a hate crime if the crime is based on a person's race or religion or ethnicity or sexual orientation. Lesbian, gay, bisexual, or transgender. Vocalist John Becker, vice president of a gay rights group, knows that hatred.
It's something that is a daily fear for LGBTQ people.
And now Becker fears something else. Actor Jussie Smollett, an openly gay black man, is accused of staging a hate crime. Here is Smollett a week ago.
There was a second person involved who was kicking me in my back. Then I look down and I see that there's a rope around my neck.
But Chicago police now say Smollett hired two alleged thugs and faked the crime because he wanted to promote his career.
My concern is that hate crimes would now publicly be met with a level of skepticism that previously didn't happen.
FBI statistics show hate crimes rose 17% to nearly 20 a day in the year 2017. Numbers from California State University show of the more than 7,100 reported, 23 were fake claims.
The number of false reports, at least the ones that we can at least somewhat verify independently through further research, we've actually found that are incredibly minuscule to the actual large numbers.
Becker says even one false report will have a chilling effect on victims who are often hesitant to come forward. And as for those who don't believe hate crimes exist,
talk to us, because we'll tell you exactly what I've just said about how real this threat is.
Researchers say preliminary numbers for last year are again showing an increase in hate crimes, but a decrease in false claims. Carolyn Presutti, VOA News, Washington.